Here at Special Effect, we're always looking for different ways to create unique custom setups. In this video, we're going to be showing you how to connect more than one controller to your console using the Titan 2 adapter. The use of multiple controllers is a good way to use a variety of controllers for a single console. For instance, if you need a verifying controller for the PS4, as well as using the Xbox Adaptive Controller and the Xbox One controller, or whether you want to use the joysticks on two separate controllers, as well as using switches by your feet. Before you begin, you'll need access to a PC or a console, such as a PS4, Xbox One, or Nintendo Switch, a Titan 2 adapter with a micro USB cable, a Titan 2 expansion kit, and some controllers. These could be controllers for a PS4, Xbox One, or the Pro controller for a Nintendo Switch. You can plug up the two controllers directly into the Titan 2. You can connect a further two controllers wirelessly using the expansion pack for the Titan 2. So this gives you up to four controllers you can connect to the Titan 2. Inside the expansion pack, you will find a Bluetooth module and an SD card. Put the SD card into the memory slot. You should hear a click confirming it's been placed in correctly. You'll have to install the Bluetooth files onto the SD card using a PC or a laptop before connecting controllers wirelessly. To do this, you'll have to download and install a free piece of software called Gtuner IV. Once it's downloaded, plug in the Titan 2 into your laptop or PC, making sure the Titan is plugged into the prog slot. Once your Titan 2 is installed onto your laptop or PC, open up Gtuner and you'll find your Titan in there. On the bottom right, click on the panel called Device Configuration. On the micro SD section, click Configure, and this will transfer the Bluetooth files needed for your Titan. For the Bluetooth module, lift the grey lid with Titan written on it. Here's where you'll be placing the Bluetooth module. Plug in the Titan 2 into your console, making sure it's plugged into the output slot. By holding down the profile up button for 2.5 seconds, you'll see horizontal lines flashing. This means that the Titan is looking for a controller to connect with. Before trying to connect the controller, make sure the controller is turned off. The way you connect varies for each controller. For the Xbox One, press the Xbox button, which will make the controller light up. Then hold the sync button until it starts flashing rapidly. A steady light will mean it's connected. You should connect the Xbox One controller first before trying to connect the other controllers. This is because the Xbox One controller will overwrite any other controllers that are connected already. For the PS4 controller, hold down the PlayStation button and the Share button at the same time until the controller starts flashing rapidly. For the Nintendo Switch Pro controller, hold down the Sync button and you should see some flashing at the bottom of the controller. Once there is a steady single light, it means it's connected. If you're using the PS4 console, you have to have a PS4 controller plugged in either wirelessly or via a wired connection. This is because the PlayStation 4 console sends out a verification code every 10 minutes searching for a PS4 controller and stops other controllers from working if it cannot find one. The same applies for the Xbox One, so you need an Xbox One controller plugged in for verification. If you want to continue using controllers over a long period of time, you can charge them using an external source such as a plug with a USB slot. If you're intending on using a PS3 controller with a PS4, then it's best to plug in the PS3 controller directly into the Titan 2. If you're plugging in another controller, such as the Xbox Adaptive Controller, into the Titan 2, then the PS4 controller has to be connected wirelessly. This is because the PS3 controller will only be charged via the Titan 2 and not an external plug source. do not plug the Titan 2 into an external plug source. There are other ways to connect two controllers to act as player one. This is done through the Copilot feature on Xbox and PC. Copilot is very useful when you want to connect a standard Xbox controller and an Xbox adaptive controller. To use Copilot, you have to use Xbox accessories, which you'll need to download for PC. You'll need to go onto Settings, Ease of Access, and then Controller. Open up the Copilot feature. Each controller has to be assigned to an ID. Then simply turn on Copilot. Both controllers should now be working as player one. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to get in touch.